it is time to go into your word. And it is written in your word, the entrance of your word gives light.
Oh, yes.
And that the light shines in darkness, and darkness cannot comprehend it. Therefore, Lord, shine in our hearts in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Bless us wonderfully through your word in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Make us hearers and doers of your word.
Amen.
In Jesus' name, we have prayed.
Amen.
Please be seated.
Edekandoku.
I welcome you into the presence of the living God. Today, the second Sunday in the month of July. And I am the living God, and the message you are going to hear this morning shall transform your life. Shall wipe away your tears.
Amen.
And will set your feet on the solid rock.
Amen.
The topic of the message is the evils of impatience. The evils of impatience. And the text is 1 Samuel chapter 13, verse 10.
Ibi chasi yon lati kanoni, iwe Samuel ikini, ori iketala, eze ikewa.
And it came to pass that as soon as he had made an end of offering, the burnt offering, behold, Samuel came. And Saul went out to meet him, that he might salute him.
Otishe, bi otishe bore ati ebo sisunwo ni pari, sikiyesi Samuel ide, Saul si jade lati lo pade re, ki o le ki.
There comes a time in your life when the devil will deceive you to think that God is too slow.
Yo tan ko ninu aye re ti satani yo tan je pe Olorun o ti fasehin ju.
At such a time, if you are not under the control of the Holy Spirit, you will miss it forever.
There
are certain things you think you are doing that are right, which are wrong. There are certain things we do in our own thinking that we are helping God, but we are actually harming ourselves. The spirit of impatience is one of the strongest spirits that have destroyed many. But this morning, by the grace of God, that demon shall be cast out in your life in Jesus'
name.
I call it an unclean spirit because it makes you unclean before God. Those who are wise, they say, God's time is the best. The word impatience has many behavioral applications. In this message, we are going to deal with some attitudes that are not good for Christians. And one of them is impatience. Or let me rather say the chief of them is impatience. What is impatience? I want to approach it from three angles. The the physical,
ninu ara,
the spiritual,
ninu emi,
and the social.
Ati ninu ibaraenise.
Physically,
ninu ara,
to be impatient means to be restless.
Ah, ninu ara, aisuru, oje aifarabale.
To be intolerant of delays.
I call I mola, I mean, I father, I say.
To demonstrate anxiety.
Latimu iwariyoko.
And to present undue eagerness to begin something. The Bible says, for everything, there is a time for it. When you do the right thing at the wrong time, you are wrong. That is why you must know about this spirit of impatience. This spirit of impatience is also uneasy or distressing desire for something. You felt uneasy. Something is pushing you and you have no power to resist. In order to satisfy your desire for something. Spiritually, what does it mean to be impatient? It is viewing God as being slow to come to one's help. In the passage read to us, there was somebody whose name was called Saul. And the name Saul means little. Somebody small. And in real life, he was small. Positionally, he was small. He came from the smallest tribe in the nation of Israel. From the tribe of Benjamin. And the Bible said he came from the smallest family in the smallest tribe. In other words, he was insignificant. But God decided to favor him. The Bible says, stature wise, he was taller than everybody. And God chose him to be the first king in the land of
Israel.
When he was told, he was overwhelmed. And he was afraid to step into such a big shoe. God came nearer again and released the Spirit to him. And with the coming of the Holy Spirit unto him, he became stabilized. He became strong. To the extent that he was able to win a war against the Philistines convincingly. So he thought that he has arrived. So he thought that he no longer needed God. The greatest mistake you can make in your life is to seek your independence from God. When you think that you don't need to consult God even in the smallest details of your life. It is a deadly mistake. So there came a time when God came and he was giving
ìlànà kan pàtó.
Samuel told him.
Samuel sọ fún pé.
Wait for me for 7 days.
Lóde mi fún ọjọ́ méje o.
I will come.
Wọ́n wá.
But the situation.
Ṣùgbọ́n àwọn àkókò wọ̀nyí.
Made it difficult for Saul to obey.
Ó wọ́n mú láti ṣòro fún Sọ́ọ̀lù láti gbọ́.
That is what you get.
Ohun tí o máa nílé o.
When you raise your problems higher than God.
Nígbà tó bá gbé ìṣòro rẹ ga ju Ọlọ́run lọ.
When you raise your enemies higher than God.
Nígbà tó bá gbé ọ̀tá rẹ ga ju Ọlọ́run lọ.
When you see your problems as insurmountable mountains.
Nígbà tó bá rí ìṣòro rẹ bí òkè tí a kò lè gùn.
You now relegate God to the background.
O wá mú Ọlọ́run lọ sí abẹ́ rẹ.
You want to use your senses instead of being in the spirit.
O fẹ́ lo ọpọlọ rẹ dípò kí o wà nínú ẹ̀mí.
That was what happened.
Ojú ṣẹlẹ̀ yìí.
So when Saul waited.
Nígbà tí Saul wá dúró.
And Samuel did not come on time.
Tí Samuel kò sì wá lákòókò.
He used his sense knowledge.
O wá lo ọpọlọ rẹ.
He told himself.
O wá sọ fún ara rẹ.
What can Samuel do that I cannot do?
Kí ni Samuel lè ṣe ọtí èmi kò lè ṣe?
I've been watching him.
Mo ti wò ó.
How he performed the sacrifice.
Bí ó ti ń ṣe ìlú ẹbọ.
I can do it myself.
Mo lè ṣe fún ara mi.
When you think you can do what God did not apportion you to do, you are making a costly mistake.
Nígbà tí o bá ń ṣe ohun tí Ọlọ́run kò yàn ọ́ láti ṣe, ó ṣe àṣìṣe tí ó mọ́ gidi.
It is pushing yourself to do what you are not qualified to do.
O ní láti máa ti ara rẹ láti ṣe ohun tí kò tọ́ ti ọ láti ṣe.
It is inability to control your desire for action.
O ní àìlágbára láti lè máa darí àwọn iṣẹ́ àti ìwà rẹ.
In the economy of God.
Nínú ìṣúná owó ti Ọlọ́run.
Obedience is paramount.
Ìgbọràn ó jẹ́ ohun tó jẹ́ kókó.
If you want to deal with God.
Bí o bá fẹ́ bá Ọlọ́run ṣe.
And you want God to deal with you.
Ó fẹ́ kí Ọlọ́run máa bá ọ ṣe.
You must forget who you are.
O gbọ́dọ̀ gbàgbé ẹni tí o jẹ́.
Forget what you know.
O gbọ́dọ̀ gbàgbé ohun tí o mọ̀.
And obey him.
Kí o sì gbọ́dọ̀ sí lẹ́nu.
No more, no less.
Kò sí ohun tó kọjá yìí.
He told the Israelites.
Ó sọ fún àwọn Israẹli.
This is what I told you.
Ohun tí mo sọ fún ilé o.
When I brought you out of Egypt.
Nígbà tí mo mú ìdẹ́rẹ́ láti ọ̀hún ilé
ìlú Egypt. My voice.
Gbọ́dọ̀ sí ohun mi.
That was the instruction God gave them.
Ohun tí Ọlọ́run sọ fún wọn rèé.
Obey my voice.
Ẹ ṣe ìgbọ́dọ̀ sí ẹnu ọ̀rọ̀ mi.
When you refuse to obey God.
Nígbà tí o bá kọ̀ láti gbọ́dọ̀ sí Ọlọ́run lẹ́nu.
You have committed a fatal mistake.
O ti ṣe àṣìṣe tó ń ṣe fún pani.
Socially.
Nínú ìbáṣẹ ẹni.
What does it mean to be impatient?
Kí ni ìtumọ̀ àìnísùúrù?
It means inability to get on with others.
Ó ní aláìlè bá àwọn tó kù ṣe.
You know there are some people.
Ǹjẹ́
wọn. They cannot relate with other people.
Àwọn kan wà tí wọn ò lè bá àwọn tó kù ṣe.
The moment things are not going their own way.
Nígbà tí ohun kan ò bá ti lọ ní ọ̀nà tiwọn. Rárá.
Everything will be turned upside down.
Ohun gbogbo náà máa yí lóko yípo.
No.
Rárá.
You must learn to relate.
O gbọ́dọ̀ kọ́ láti lè báni ṣe.
Christianity.
Ìgbàgbọ́.
Is not a religion.
Kì í ṣe ẹ̀sìn lásán.
No.
Rárá.
Like Islam, like Buddhism.
Bóyá bí Islam yọ tàbí àwọn tó kù rárá.
Not at all.
Rárá.
Christianity is relationship with God.
Christianity only ìbáṣepọ̀ láàrin àti Ọlọ́run.
Relationship.
A ìbáṣepọ̀.
And the Bible says.
Let it be pé.
Can two work together except they be agreed?
Ìtẹ́ àwọn méjì lè máa rìn bí wọn ò bá ní ìmọ̀ṣọ̀kan.
So.
Nítorí náà.
If socially you cannot work with other people.
Nínú ìbára ẹni ṣe bí o bá lè rìn pẹ̀lú àwọn tó kù.
You cannot move with other people.
Ó lè máa rìn pẹ̀lú àwọn tó kù.
Means you cannot walk with God.
Èyí wọ̀n tí o lè bá Ọlọ́run rìn.
Because the Bible says.
Kò sí pé bíbélì wípé.
If you cannot love the person you see.
Bí o bá lè bẹ̀rẹ̀ ẹni tí o rí.
How can you claim to have loved God whom you did not see?
Báwo ni tí o lè máa sọ pé o ti fẹ́ràn Ọlọ́run tí o kò rí?
So you need to understand that.
Nítorí náà gbọ́dọ̀ mọ iye nǹkan wọ̀nyí.
That is why.
Ìdí ni.
Many people cannot enjoy the company of decent people.
Ọ̀pọ̀lọpọ̀ lè gbádùn. Ibi tí àwọn ènìyàn gidi bá wà.
Because of the spirit of impatience.
Nítorí ẹ̀mí àìnísùúrù.
Now we want to see what are the agents of impatience. There are five agents. When they are present in your life, they will make you impatient. There are five types of spirits. If they overwhelm you, you will become impatient. Number one, the spirit of fear. The spirit of fear. In 1 Samuel chapter 13, verse 12, therefore said I, the Philistines will come down now upon me to Gilgal, and I have not made supplication unto the Lord. I forced myself therefore and offered a burnt offering.
It does not let me say we back. Nisi la wafilisi yoko kale tondo wa ziki gali. Beli emiko iti chodu wa loju. Emisi chela amisi. Mosi liya bosi suna.
You see, the fear of being overwhelmed by the force of the enemies can make you impatient for God.
Eru wipe awantare yo kori re. Oli teki oshie amisi ru folon.
I want you to pay attention to this.
Mokaki otati se fwe yo.
There are only three legitimate fears in your life. Three fears that are legitimate for you to have. Number one, the fear of God. It is legitimate. When you fear God, you're alright. Two, the fear of sin. When you are afraid to sin against God, that is a legitimate fear. Number three, the fear of the judgment of God. When you fear not to come under the judgment of God, those are the three legitimate fears. All other fears, they are illegitimate. The fears of man, the fears of death, the fears of the future, the fears of this or that, the fears of the enemy, they are illegitimate. Because greater is the God who is in you than he that is in the world. So some made a great mistake by surrendering to the spirit of fear. What is fear? Fear is apprehension of an imaginary danger. You think of something that is imaginary. It is not real. If you are driving on a highway, when it is sunny, at times you look ahead of you and you see something with a resemblance of fire or water. We call it mirage. If you are the fearful one, you will slam on your brake. But if you are not afraid, one thing you will discover is this. As you are moving forward, the supposed fire or water will be receding. You will never meet it. As long as you are moving forward, the same thing in your Christian life. Fear is a mirage designed by the devil to stop your advancement. But the moment you move forward in Christ, it will disappear. Unfortunately, many believers like Saul have been intimidated by the numbers of their enemies.
Abalakwe ni yobi solu ni atifia ruba ni doriya
Forgetting the declaration of the scripture that those who are with us are more than those who are with them.
What if I go to be really so and it's your Pelua? Oh, you are doing Pelua.
The moment you accept the Lord Jesus is your life. According to Romans chapter 8 verse 31, the Bible says, if God be for us, who can be against us? When the Lord is with you, there is no power that can overwhelm you. Therefore, do not allow fear to stampede you into taking regrettable decisions. In the book of Numbers chapter 14, when you begin to read from verse 6 to 10, the sight of the Philistines, the sight of the giants, actually intimidated the Israelites. Don't you ever make that mistake. Don't allow fear to stampede you into taking steps that will be dangerous for your survival. That is why, instead of having fear, have faith in God. The second spirit that is agent of impatience is the spirit of distress. The spirit of distress. In 1 Samuel chapter 13, and verse 6, when the men of Israel saw that they were in a strait, for the people were distressed, then the people did hide themselves in caves, and in thickets, and in the rocks, and in high places, and in pits. You must be very, very careful of the spirit of distress in your life. What does it mean to be distressed? To be distressed is to be in this uncomfortable condition. It is to lose a sense of living in danger. You are distressed. You are discouraged. You are disappointed. You are overwhelmed. You are inundated by the force of the enemy. Especially that of your conscience. Let me tell you this morning, one of the greatest powers that can break your resistance in life is the power of your conscience. In the book of Genesis, chapter 42, and verse 21, the Bible says, the brothers of Joseph, when they stood before Joseph, even though they did not know that the man standing before them was Joseph. The Bible said, when Joseph started to speak to them, they felt distressed. They were distressed because their consciences was reminding them of the they have done it, let me tell you the truth today.
You don't follow me.
If your Christianity will be powerful, you need to have a good conscience toward God. The Bible says, if our conscience condemns us, God is greater than our conscience. That is why, when your conscience is not pure, you are already a victim of distress. Saul was distressed. Saul was distressed because he lacked courage in his ability to sustain the victory he had recorded. You
need
what happened to Saul here? When God gave him the Holy Spirit, as I told you, people looked down on him because he did not come from a recognized family. Because he did not have the background of a good training to be a warrior. So they looked at him.
Where
can this man save Israel? But God turned everything in his favor. He went to war. And he destroyed the enemies. Then the people changed their opinion
concerning
him. And that is the purpose of God in your life. There are people will change their opinion concerning you. That where they thought you cannot succeed, you will succeed. Where they say you cannot be victorious, you become victorious. Success to get into your head.
Yeah.
I used to tell people, it is not a problem for God to make you successful. It is not a problem for God to bless you, make you a millionaire, a billionaire. That is not a problem for God. It is not a problem for God to promote you. From general messenger to general manager, it is not difficult for God to do it. But the problem is this. When God makes you successful, how do you handle success in your life? Listen, somebody said, you don't know the true worth of anybody until you give him power.
Yes.
Oh, my young, I've got a
yes.
When you give people power, if they don't misuse it, when you now know their worth. How many of you here are listening to me? Millionaire today and not be proud in your heart against God. How many of you today, if God will make you the head of your business organization, who will not become proud to God? That was the problem of Saul. Not fail. Listen to me carefully. Job said,
Job,
what I fear was what came to me. Instead of you fearing God, if you fear failure in your life, you will fail. Was afraid lest he would not be able to sustain his willing streak.
Oh, sure,
many believers like Saul were always relationship with God because they want to sustain their winning streak.
Ọ̀pọ̀lọpọ̀ nígbàgbọ́ bí ọba Saulu, Olúwa ní ìnísùrù pẹ̀lú Ọlọ́run, nítorí pé wọ́n fẹ́ gbé dúró ìṣẹ́gun wọn.
If you are with God,
bí ọba wà pẹ̀lú Ọlọ́run,
the Bible says,
ìbéèrè wí pé,
I have served the Lord always before
him. Mo ti gbé Olúwa kan iwájú mi nígbà gbogbo.
He is at my right hand.
Wọ́n wà ní ọwọ́ ọ̀tún mi.
Therefore,
nítorí náà,
I shall not be moved.
A kì yóò sí mi ní ipò.
I shall not be moved.
A kì yóò sí mi ní ipò.
You serve the Lord.
Bí ọba tó gbé Olúwa kan iwájú mi.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
The third agent of impatience is the spirit of desertion.
Ikosile.
In 1 Samuel chapter
13,
verse
8,
and he tarried 7 days according to the set time that Samuel had appointed. But Samuel came now to kill God, and the people were scattered from
him. Ọ́n sì dúró ní ìjọ méje dé àkókò tí Samuel dá fún. Ṣùgbọ́n Samuel kò wá sí Gilgali. Àwọn ènìyàn náà sì túká kúrò ní ọ̀dọ̀ rẹ̀.
Listen.
Tẹ́tí o.
I learned a lesson in my life.
Mo kọ́ ẹ̀kọ́ kan nínú ayé mi.
I was in the service of the first day of the year, January 1977.
Mo wà nínú ìpéjọpọ̀ ọjọ́ kìíní ọdún kìíní ọjọ́ kìíní oṣù kìíní nínú ọdún 1977.
And God said,
Ọlọ́run ti wá wí pé,
let all congregants ask something in particular from me that they will bring before me come next year.
Jẹ́ kí olúkúlùkù ènìyàn tó wà níwájú mi lónìí bèrè nǹkan pàtó níwájú mi tí wọ́n mú wá ní ọdún tó ń bọ̀.
I said, God,
máa gbé Olúwa,
I want to come here in January 1978 with my future partner.
Mo fẹ́ wá sí bí báyìí ní ọjọ́ kìíní oṣù kìíní ọdún 1978 pẹ̀lú aláfẹ́sọ́nà mi.
By that time, I have no future partner.
Nígbà náà mi ò ní àfẹ́sọ́nà kankan.
I set out to pray.
Àwọn wọ́n jáde láti gbàdúrà.
January went.
Oṣù kìíní kọjá.
February, March, April, May, June, July.
Ó ní oṣù kéje.
August, September, October, November.
What you got for that day?
December, Christmas, wait.
What you get, Dila? Get it ready now. Well,
I said, God,
are
you going to disappoint me?
Oh, yeah, me couldn't be.
Do you know when God answered my prayer?
In your mind, that your Lord come now and do
my prayer on December 31st, 4 p.m.
On one day, I do not mean me. Oh, she can't. I don't call it. Look, but she can't do that. Me, I don't mean it like that again.
Four.
Oh, I go more.
I go man.
That was when I set my eyes on the woman I was to marry.
Hallelujah. Oh, that people feel too quiet.
I spoke to her.
What about her?
And the rest is history. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
What
did
I say? I went to Olorunda.
Mo lo si Olorunda.
With her the second day.
Pẹ̀lú wọn ni ọjọ́ náà lọ́jọ́ kejì.
What difference does it make?
Kí ni ìyàtọ̀ rẹ̀?
If God answer my prayer in January.
Bóyá Olúwa dábì náà dúró mi ní oṣù
kejì. If I meet in April.
Bóyá dábì náà dúró oṣù kejì
náà. If he answered it in October.
Bóyá dábì náà dúró oṣù
kejì náà. It doesn't make a difference.
Kò ní ìyàtọ̀.
What I told him was that.
Ohun tí mo sọ fún
rẹ̀. I want to call.
Mo fẹ́ wá sí
ayé. To the princess of 1st of January 1978 with my future partner. And he beat the record. December 31st, the last day.
Mo fẹ́ wá sí ibí báyìí ní ọjọ́ báyìí ní ìgbà báyìí. Olúwa sì ṣe ní ọjọ́ tó kẹ́yìn.
That was what Saul did not learn.
Ohun tí Saul kò kẹ́kọ̀ọ́ rẹ̀ rèé.
He was expecting God to summon to come either the second day, the third day, the fifth day, on the seventh day. He did not see Saul as Samuel.
Ọ̀rẹ́ ti Samuel láti wá ní ọjọ́ kìíní, ọjọ́ kejì, ọjọ́ kẹta, ọjọ́ keje pàápàá kò tún ìrìn Samuel.
Maybe I am talking to somebody here this morning. waiting on God for something important, and God has set a target for you, and you think that that time is gone, that God will not come back. Wait for God. Wait for God. He will always keep his time.
Yo,
hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. The Bible said, immediately Saul finished the offering. Who appeared?
Samuel. Let's look at this. Saul,
and what has been done cannot be undone. Be very careful about thinking that God has deserted you. What is desertion? It is an unpalatable experience of being abandoned by one's followership.
You
become a captain without soldiers. But Jesus experienced it. And he was victorious. Come with me into the book of John, chapter 16, verses 32 and
33.
Behold, the hour cometh, yea, is now come, that ye shall be scattered, everyone to his own, and shall leave me alone. And yet I am not alone, because the Father is with me.
Hallelujah.
These things I have spoken unto you, that in me ye might have peace. In the world ye shall have tribulation, but be of good cheer, I have overcome the world. Jesus was deserted by his disciples. All the apostles left him.
But
he knew God, his Father, did not leave him. David said, when my father and my mother forsake me, then the Lord will take me up.
It is impossible
for your father, for your mother, to forsake you. It is possible for your husband to forsake you. It is possible for your wife to forsake you. It is possible for your children to forsake you. But your Creator will not forsake you.
Amen.
If you know that God, and you are faithful to God, he will not forsake
you.
In the book of
Jeremiah,
chapter 20, I want to read verse
11.
Jeremiah chapter 20, and verse 11. But the Lord is with me as a mighty, terrible one. Therefore my persecutors shall stumble,
amen,
and they shall not prevail.
Amen.
They shall be greatly ashamed, for they shall not prosper. Their everlasting confusion shall never be forgotten.
Amen.
Say one with God is
majority.
When you are with God, God is with you. When you are for God, God is for you. There is no cause for alarm. Spirit number four. The spirit of insubordination. The spirit of insubordination.
Emi ayonuso.
Ayonusi. Praise the Lord.
Ayonusi.
Happy New Year. First Samuel. Chapter 13. Verses 9 and 10. And Saul said, bring either a burnt offering to me and peace offerings. And he offered the burnt offering. And it came to pass that as soon as he had made an end of offering the burnt offering, behold, Samuel came. And Saul went out to meet him that he might salute him. Listen to what he did. He offered offerings. Burnt offering. Peace offering. But he was not a priest. It was not his duty. You see, there are some people, they overstep their boundaries. Insubordination. You do what you are not qualified to do. You trespass. Impatience makes one to overstep one's boundary of responsibility. God has order. He has limitations. Don't go beyond this world. You may be physically qualified. For instance, if something happened now, and there's a prophecy, God said the Lord, let my servant lay hands upon the people. I want to do wonders. Let my servant lay the hand upon that sick. I want to deliver. I want to heal. If you are not ordained, no matter the degree of your spirituality, if you try it, you will regret it. Because you are not commissioned. That is why we need to be very careful. Again, the spirit of insubordination. God is not the author of confusion. King Uzziah committed the sin of insubordination and became a leper. He overstepped his boundary. He usurped the authorities of the priests.
Oh no, Asha Alufa.
Therefore, he became a leper.
Oh,
do not be too forward to show your knowledge or expertise. Avoid being forward. Wait till your appointed time. If you have a gift, if you have a talent, you received it from God. God knows the time when he needed that gift in you. He knew the occasion for what he needed that gift for. And he will bring you out at the right time. But there are many people
who
can perform better than the pastor. I'm going to start my own ministry. You will start your ministry, but you will be missing in the kingdom of God. Because God has not commissioned you for that. Impatience has pushed you.
Yes.
Number five. The spirit of over ambition. It is very good to be ambitious. But when you are over ambitious, that is where the problem comes. It is very good to be ambitious. The Bible says, wants to become a bishop. Oh, it's a good thing. But the conditions must be met. There are many people today who call themselves elders, bishops, who do not respect what the Bible says to
Bishop, you want to
in 1 Samuel, chapter 13, verses 11 and 12. And Samuel said, what hast thou done? And Saul said, because I saw that the people were scattered from me, and that thou camest not within the days appointed, and that the Philistines gathered themselves together at Michmash. Therefore said I, the Philistines will come down now upon me to Gilgal. And I have not made supplication unto the Lord. I fold myself therefore and offered a burnt offering.
Samuel is in big bay. Kini washe in son, sit down, pay. Nitori, mi ripe, I want you not to come through, not on me. Woko si wa na o ko jo ti o da awon filistini ti ko awon jo ni mikmashi nitori na le mi se wi pe mi ti si ile awon filistini yo so kale to mi wa sigigali be le mi ko ti ju oluwa loju emi ti ti ara mi si bo ti lo ebo fifun na.
Listen to me.
That is from you.
You may have good intention.
O le ni ero daada.
But if your intention did not agree with the instructions of God, it is bad intention.
Bi a ipinu re bi ko ba jo ba lodi si ipinu Olorun o je ipinu ti ko dara.
Look at what Saul did
here. Egbe o ti Saul se nibi yi.
He gave three reasons.
Of one iredi meta.
Number one,
the kini,
the people were scattered from him.
Awon eniyan tuka kuro lodo mi.
Number two,
Ikeji.
Samuel did not come at the appointed time. Number three,
Iketa.
The enemies are approaching. All these things, with common sense, they are very good. They are very good reasons. When you view it from human angle, but Saul was totally ignorant of who God is. God was never late. What God was doing was to bring all the enemies of Saul together. So God was working. He was bringing them. Say, all of you, come. So that he can give Saul one final blow and give him total victory. Unfortunately, that is the approach many of us are taking. When you have problems upon problems, started to pray and fast. Instead of the problem going down, it appears it is going up. And you begin to say, I don't think God is concerned about me. I don't think God is thinking about me anymore. Then the devil will suggest to you, heaven helps those who help themselves. Then you want to help yourself. Then you go to seek for help outside of God. That was the mistake of Saul.
As he said,
he The Bible says, he that will come will soon come.
And
God will come at the right time. He will never be too fast. He will never be too late. He will come at the right time. The Bible says, at the right time, Jesus came to the world. He had been slain from the foundation of the world. But at the right time, he manifested to take away sin. That is why he was telling the Jews, before Abraham your father was, I am. I have been from the beginning. The Israelites, when they were in Egypt, they were crying. They thought God had neglected them. Somewhere, hundreds of miles away, God was preparing Moses for the liberation of his people. I want to let you know, if you think God has forgotten you, God is occupied somewhere thinking about you. God is preparing somebody somewhere for you. Only you need to wait for him. You need to wait for him. Saul made the mistake of his life when he usurped the sacred duty of the priest. He said, I pushed myself, I fought. I don't know what you are forcing yourself to do. Some of you, because you want to be a citizen of America, that is why you entered into illegal marriage. You left your wife in Nigeria. You come to America, you take another wife. You take another husband because you want to become a citizen. You disappointed God. And that is why Satan has crept into your life. But today, if you will confess your sins, if you will repent genuinely, Jesus has come. There was no repentance for Saul. Job said, I wish there would be a this man that means it's somebody who will plead between him and God. But there was none. But Job saw it afar.
Job, why you are doing it?
I know that my Redeemer lives.
Mama, God,
today,
tomorrow,
don't have that excuse. Jesus has come. The Bible says, he is before God now. Praying for me. Fighting my battle. So I can know that whatever comes, I shall be where God wants me to be. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
How can you overcome the spirit of impatience? Concern on this pulpit. Number one, be conscious of the loss you will suffer if you are impatient. Quantify your losses before you become impatient. In the book of Numbers, chapter 20, verses 10 to 12. And Moses and Aaron gathered the congregation together before the rock. And he said unto them, hear now, ye rebels, must we fetch you water out of this rock? And Moses lifted up his hand And with his rod, he smote the rock twice. And the water came out abundantly. And the congregation drank, and their beasts also. And the Lord spake unto Moses and Aaron, because ye believed me not.